Hello everyone, this is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. I will talk about the anatomy of the ureter. So I will talk about the lens and the origin, the course of the ureter, the posterior relation and anterior relation, arterial supply and the nerve supply of the ureter, constrictions of the ureter, and the lymph drainage and X-ray appearance of the ureter. Okay, start by the lens. The ureter is about 10 inches long, 5 inches in the abdomen, and 5 inches in the pelvis. The origin, it is the continuation of the renal pelvis. Regarding the course, it is divided into abdominal part, which is 5 inches long, and the pelvic part 5 inches long. The abdominal part of the ureter begins from the renal pelvis to the bifurcation of the common iliac artery. The pelvic part begins from the bifurcation of the common iliac artery to the posterosuperior angle of the urinary bladder. Regarding the posterior relation of the ureter, it descends on the psoas major muscle and the genitofemoral nerve, then crosses the bifurcation of the common iliac artery, then descends on the side wall of the pelvis. So psoas major, bifurcation of the common iliac artery, and the side wall of the pelvis. Regarding the anterior relation of the ureter, from above downward, this is the right ureter, and this is the left ureter. From above downward, renal vessels are present in front of the renal pelvis. So renal vessels on the right side and also renal vessels on the left side. Then here on the right side, the second part of the duodenum, and on the left side, the body of the pancreas. Then third part of the duodenum, this is the third part of the duodenum. On the left side, it is the jejunum, this one. Then on the right side, it is crossed by 4 arteries. And on the left side, it is also crossed by 4 arteries. The 4 arteries crossing in front of the right ureter are: this is the first one, the right gonadal artery, right colic artery, iliocolic artery, and the superior mesenteric artery itself, this one. On the left side, gonadal artery, left gonadal artery, left colic artery, and 2 sigmoid arteries. Then the ureter is crossed by the root of the mesentery on the right side, and on the left side, the sigmoid mesocolon. The ureter, the right ureter, is crossed by the terminal part of the ileum, this one. The left ureter is crossed by the sigmoid colon, and in the pelvis, it is crossed by the vas deferens in the male or broad ligament in the female. So again, the anterior relation of the ureter, anterior relation of the right ureter, renal vessels, second part of the duodenum, third part of the duodenum, 4 arteries, gonadal, right colic, iliocolic artery, superior mesenteric artery, in the root of the mesentery, terminal part of the ileum, and then vas deferens or broad ligament of the ureter. Regarding the anterior relation of the left ureter, again, renal vessels, body of the pancreas, jejunum, 4 arteries, left gonadal artery, left colic artery, 2 sigmoid arteries, sigmoid mesocolon, and this is sigmoid colon, and vas deferens or broad ligament of the uterus. So these are the anterior relations of the ureter. Now the arterial supply of the ureter. It receives arterial supply from many arteries along its course. The first one, this one, from the renal artery, then from the gonadal artery, then from the abdominal aorta itself, from the common iliac artery, from the internal iliac artery, and from the inferior vesical or uterine artery. So the arterial supply of the ureter from above downward, from the renal, from the gonadal, from the abdominal aorta, okay, from the common iliac, from the internal iliac, from the inferior vesical or uterine artery in the female. Regarding the nerve supply of the ureter and the referred pain from the ureter. Nerve supply, sympathetic and parasympathetic. Sympathetic, lowest splenic nerve, 2T12, and the first lumbar splenic nerve. So sympathetic nerve supply of the ureter from T12 and L1 splenic nerves. Lowest splenic nerve and the first lumbar splenic nerve. Regarding the parasympathetic, from the pelvic splenic nerves, S2, 3, and 4. Regarding the referred pain from the kidney and the ureter, pain is referred to the dermatomes T12 and L1 according to the sympathetic nerve supply. So pain radiates to. It will radiate to T12 and L1, lumbar region, anterior abdominal wall, and external genitalia. So, nerve supply of the ureter and the kidney, actually. Okay, nerve supply of the ureter, okay, sympathetic, lowest splenic nerve, T12, and the first lumbar splenic nerve. Parasympathetic, it is the pelvic splenic nerves, S2, 3, and 4. Referred pain, it will radiate to dermatomes, T12 and L1, so it will radiate to the lumbar region, anterior abdominal wall, and external genitalia. Then lymph drainage of the ureter. The upper part of the ureter drains into para-aortic lymph nodes. The middle part of the ureter drains into common iliac lymph nodes. The lower part of the ureter drains into internal iliac lymph nodes. So lymph drainage of the ureter, upper part, para-aortic lymph nodes, middle part, common iliac lymph nodes, and the lower part into the internal iliac lymph nodes. Constrictions of the ureter. The ureter has three constrictions. The first one at the pelvi-ureteric junction. The second one where it crosses the bifurcation of the common iliac artery. And the third constriction is the intramural part inside the wall of the urinary bladder. What is the clinical importance of the constrictions of the ureter? These constrictions are common sites for the arrest of the stones. So the stones usually arrest at the pelvic-ureteric junction, at the bifurcation of the common iliac artery, and in the intramural part. Regarding the X-ray appearance of the ureter, in plain X-ray and in IVP, this is IVP, okay, the ureter descends on the tips of the lumbar transverse processes, okay, tips of the lumbar transverse processes, then it crosses the sacroiliac joint, sacroiliac joint, this one, then the ischial spine or ischial spine. So, X-ray appearance of the ureter in plain X-ray, it descends along the tips of the lumbar transverse processes, in front of the sacroiliac joint, and then on the ischial spine. This is IVP. These are the minor calyces. This is major calyx, renal pelvis, and this is the ureter, okay? And this is the urinary bladder. The ureter descends on the tips of the lumbar transverse processes, on the sacroiliac joint, and then on the ischial spine. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.